He's the worship Him. Hallelujah. Come on, let's lift our hands and worship Him. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Oh, my peace, oh, my peace.
blessed be the name of the Lord.
What a comfort you are. What a comfort you are. What a comfort you are. What a comfort you are, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Especially tonight. First of all, we want to give thanks. We're back in our sanctuary.
Yes, we are.
The Lord preserved our sanctuary.
Yes.
The Lord let the storm pass by.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I say thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. Let the storm pass by and preserve our sanctuary and preserve us. And look what miracles is in the church. And look what testimonies we're going to be hearing. What God has done this last week for the church. My God. They're on the pantry shelf of your heart tonight. And we're going to be feeding from testimonies of miracles.
Yes.
What God has done. How God has prevailed. And Jehovah God watched over his people.
Yes.
And kept them and abided with them. My, I'm anticipating victory for a long time to come. From this great miracle that God has done. I say, give him the glory again.
Hallelujah.
We cannot praise him enough now. We can't praise him enough. We can't praise him enough. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. What God has done, what God has done, what God has done. Now, while we're praying and we're giving God thanks, I want us to pray for the Roller family tonight. Brother Steve Roller Sr. is here in the church. Brother Steve Jr. is here. Sister Diane, the family. Sister Michelle, of course. And but up in Tallahassee, his mother, Mary Jane Holloman, husband Michael. Today, they were greeted with the sad news. Grandmother Roller here, Ann Roller, the grandmother. She's not feeling up to par tonight, so let's pray for her. But they were greeted with the news that the brother here to Steve Jr., the son, Abram, he's been here to worship. I think he's 33 years old, is that right, Steve?
32.
They were greeted with the news that they found him dead and found him passed away.
Yes.
And the family's bearing that tonight.
Yes.
The brother, the son here,
yes,
of Steve and Mary Jane, and the brother to Steve Jr., and Diane, the family intermixed here, the Rosellas, intermarried with the Rosellas family. And they found him. I think they found him in the home, did they? They found him passed away at 32. So let's pray for them tonight. Let's reach out for Steve, the father, the brother back here.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Diane, the children, the families that are related. Let's pray for Mary Jane. She's very fragile. The mother is very fragile. She's been here many times in worship. She loves the Lord. Michael, the husband of Mary Jane. But let's pray for the family. Grandmother Lower tonight. Let's pray for the family. That God will help them the loss of this 32-year-old son. Just suddenly gone from them. Comfort their hearts, Lord Jesus.
Yes. Right. Yes.
Comfort their hearts,
yes,
Lord Jesus.
Please.
Comfort their hearts.
Yes.
And carry them through the days to come. And then we want to pray for our sister Debbie Harrison. She'll be facing early morning open heart surgery Monday morning. She's in critical care unit. And Blake, this is my brother Terry's wife, Terry Harrison's wife here. And Debbie is a courageous person. She's been very ill. And one last hope that the medical world has is this open heart surgery. But we know the hope really is our God and Savior. He really is the hope. He is really our hope. He's really Brother Terry's hope, the family's hope. And so we want to pray much. Then here's another need. We want to pray for Sister Karen Hanley. Her husband Matthew went to be with the Lord this morning, Manatee Memorial. And I prayed with him last night about 8:30 in Manatee. Asked God to go with him and take him over the shore. And I was confident the Lord did. And he's now facing the resurrection of the just, and I believe God will remember him and his soul before him. So let's pray for Karen, his wife, and ask God to be with her. And then all the rest of the people that are yet scattered out across the country, I'm not sure where, I think Sister Kendra's in Indiana, and then I believe that Sister Sherry and Bob, the last I heard they were going to Michigan. I'm not sure just where they are tonight. But let's pray for them and anyone else left up in Georgia, Tennessee, up in that area, that they may have gone through the storm. We're glad to see you that made the journey back, and God was with you in your shelters and your homes where you stayed. And God was with us here. And though we lost power here, and the people suffered in their homes without power, here on the campus without power, but I got such an encouraging call from a couple that used to be here with us, and they're praying about returning to the church here. They live in Chattanooga, Tennessee, Brother David and Tammy Hofer. And he called me today, and Brother David said, Brother Marlowe, of course, the meeting in Tennessee, I was at Kingsport. He really and Tammy really got a blessing. They came and renewed their experience with God, touched the Lord again, and they're praying about what to do now to be back with the church. And so he said, I watched you all have service Wednesday night in the parking lot. And he said, only my mother church, Bradenton, could not be defeated by the Florida Power and Light, having no lights in the building. They went out on the parking lot and let their light shine. Praise the name of the Lord. That's the way it ought to be now. That's the way the church should do it. And I am appreciative of the church that gathered Wednesday night in the semi-darkness around us, but we had church. We're not defeated, and the Lord was good. So we have much to praise him for. Now I'll take request. Sister Mary, you have your hand raised.
Pray for Sister Kendra and them, because they're on their way home. They're in Valdosta.
Who is this?
Sister Kendra, they're in Valdosta.
Oh, they're on their way home. All right, they're returning from Indiana. All right, we'll pray for Sister Kendra and the boys. They'll get back home all right. Pray for the Walkers. I enjoy the Walkers. They're good people. And I miss them here in the service tonight. Sherry and Mom. Brother Adolph.
month and a half ago, he died. He passed away. And 3 days ago, sister passed away.
Oh, my. Where were they?
She went to the hospital with a pain in her stomach, and they gave her an anesthesia, and she never came back out of that. Just passed on. Be with the Lord.
Their family, did you say?
Diana's brother and sister.
Oh, her brother and sister.
Yes. Yes.
Can we reach out to Sister Diana tonight over here? Sister Diana, her heart, admire her life, and the family, her brother and her sister. Oh my. All right. All right. Sister Juan Michon.
Bev is really not feeling good today, and she's facing a different change in her life, and I want everybody to pray that she'll make the right decisions, because she has an opportunity to go to Louisville and get help with her liver problem, and she's thinking about moving, so I just want it to be the Lord's will.
Let it be the Lord's will.
So I have another unspoken request. My nephew's daughter is back on drugs again, and she has 3 kids, and she's just leaving the kids, and that's not a good thing.
Right. Well, remember that request.
Good to see Sister Durrett home.
Yes, we are so happy. Sister Durrett, welcome back home. You've been gone so long, you've missed you so much, and we tried our best to take care of the Carlson while you were gone. We're sure we couldn't do it like you do. But we're glad to see you home again through the storm and delayed airline flights, but you're home. Thank God it's good to see Sister Durrett back home. Amen. Amen.
Yes, Sister Santos is back there also. It's good to see her back.
Yes, Sister Santos. Oh, my, my. It's so good to see you. You're looking very bright. We're glad to see you, Sister Santos.
Right.
Welcome, welcome home. And anyone else we may be overlooking, not seeing. Sister Lisa, we're so glad to see you.
Yeah. Hi. Yeah.
We have missed you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah. I want to say, where have you been? We've just missed you so much. And we're so glad you're home.
Yeah.
And you always, Tanya and you were twins back there. And I missed the other twin. Praise God. So welcome home. All right, and we want to pray for all of God's people now. You may know some that we don't know. Sister Elizabeth Knight's back. She's on the campus. I miss Sister Eva May tonight. Let's remember her in prayer. And Sister Shirley, you have any news on her request for prayer? Sister Eva May.
She's okay. She just overdid it today working in the yard, but she's not.
Well, she can do that, you know. You can do that very easily right now in this Florida heat. Humidity in the yard, you can get hot in a hurry. And so be careful, be careful, be careful. All right, we're going to pray. Now, I don't want to pray alone. Are you going to pray with me?
Yes.
Are you going to follow your pastor in prayer?
Yes.
All right, then why don't we all just rise up together and join together in prayer. In prayer tonight. All of us, every one of us, go before God. Praise the name of the Lord. Heavenly Father, we come to you on bending knee and bending heart. And we come tonight and thank you, first of all, for your goodness and your mercy and all that you have done to give us this testimony of praise and worship. And we are praying, God, that you will help us. We are praying, Lord, every moment we can. Oh God, continue to look down with mercy and with goodness upon the sick, the bereaved, and those that are crying in pain. Tonight, those that are suffering loss in family, those that are suffering family, siblings, members of the family. Oh God, tonight, look down upon your people with the kindness of God and the love of God, and may you continue to let us see your greatness and your glory And the marvelous wonders of your magic voice. Oh, but you are good. Oh, but you are so good. You're so merciful. You're so kind. You're so sweet. And you're so gentle. And you are the compassionate Savior that we take our troubles to. And tonight we pray for victory. Victory, victory, victory in the house of God. We pray for every man, woman, child, boy, and girl. We pray that you'll help each one. Every need in the hospital, every special need, Sister Debbie Harrison, Lord. Oh God, tonight, go ahead with an angel before her and guide the way and give her strength Monday morning. Oh, Savior, let there be a miracle in Blake Hospital. Let there be a miracle in Blake Hospital. God, comfort the hearts of the lower family and be with those that are bereaved and suffering to care and heal all of your people in every need, in every way, and sanctify us and keep us. And Lord, bless the people who lost their homes in the storm. Be with the people in the Keys tonight. They're suffering, Lord. Oh, how they're suffering. And the damage done in South Florida and in Texas and across this nation. There are those that are suffering. Comfort them. Make a way for them. Open the door of mercy for them. And we'll give you the praise. We'll give you the praise. In the name of Jesus.
Praise your wonderful name.
I just want to praise him. I just want to praise him. I want to offer him praise. Oh, Father, I praise you. Oh, Father, how good you are. Comfort those who are. Comfort the lonely, the lost, and the afraid. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the church be a shining light. We'll give you the praise. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Do we have an orchestra number? Do we have a song for the offering? Praise God. Right. We're going to receive our offering. Everyone's going to give abundantly. And may God bless you as you go to the offering box tonight. I thank you for giving. I thank you for giving. May God bless every dime, every tithe offering, every penny, every dollar. May God bless the church as we give unto the Lord. Praise God. Prepare to give. The offering box is there. It's open for you. And you can go place the offering. There's a freedom to give what you feel, what you have, and God is giving you. Praise the name of the Lord. God is good to us. God is good to us. God is good to us. And let's pray. God will bless the remainder of this service. Praise God. I think I'm not going to go ahead and say anything more right now. I'm going to watch the Spirit. And there may be some of you that have testimonies of the miracle God has done for you, and the storm has passed by and you have the miracle. The storm is gone and you have the miracle. Praise God. Look what the storm left you. The storm left you the miracle, left us the miracle. Praise God. So I'm going to just wait on the Lord. I'm going to watch and pray. And it may be some of you have outstanding miracles God has done. Praise God. So we're going to give right now. And may the Lord bless you for giving. And amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, my reason, Lord.
Jesus, I praise as God.
Holy Ghost inspired body of Christ, many membered body, the Church of the Living God. That's who we are tonight. We have many members, and we're in one body. And you feel free. This assembly is never going to be bound by man's tradition. The Holy Ghost is here. The Holy Ghost is present in you. And whatever miracle God's given you, you let the Holy Ghost share it with us tonight. There's no respect of persons here. Any one of the elders, any one of the men of God, any one of the handmaidens of the Lord, any child, we are ready for a new chapter in the Church of the Living God. We are ready for the feast day to be proclaimed. Praise the name of the Lord. I said, we are ready for the feast day to be proclaimed. Come and dine, children. Isn't that what Jesus said? Isn't that what he said? Come and dine. Everybody get hungry. Start eating. Amen. 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 Praise God.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Mr. Pat, praise God.
I watched that storm all night long.
Yes, you did.
I prayed. I saw the tiles, roof tiles on the church, and they were just blowing in the wind. And I said, God, don't take the roof. Yes. Don't let that take the roof.
Yes.
And just within a few minutes, I saw the tiles blowing off. But the roof stayed. The roof stayed. That was all that was wrong. A few tiles. And then I heard this horrible explosion. And I know that it was the transformers close to my house. And then I heard a humongous thud hit my roof. And I said, oh God, don't take the roof of this little house. Lord, please don't take our little roof. And Renee and I were sitting there. And we got up the next morning. And of course, my yard is trashed. And,
yes.
And my grandson is going to clean it for me, by the way. And but I looked, and there were it was like a pure, humongous log on my roof.
That's right.
And Brother Mike had to cut it up with a chainsaw. Couldn't even get it through the gate for the trash. It was so huge, and there was like three of them. But you know what? It didn't knock a hole in the roof. And I had two that fell up against the house that were leaning right on the house.
My God.
And I don't know what kept them from just knocking a humongous hole in that roof.
Right.
Nor the side of that house. It could have taken the whole side of that little house off. But you know what?
Yeah.
I serve a living God that takes care of his people.
Yeah.
He takes care of his people.
Yeah.
I tell you, I am blessed. I am blessed tonight that I'm able to stand here and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the storm and the calm after. When you look outside of the water, it is so calm and it's so beautiful. And the sun is shining. And you think, just a few days ago, the wind was blowing through this church at 60 miles an hour out there. I saw the palm trees bend. The tops of those palm trees were touching the ground. And I thought, my God, what a mighty God you are. You let it come through and you let us see it. There has to be, and I said to myself, there has to be a lesson in this. And there is. He is a mighty God that I serve. He could have taken all of us. And that storm could have taken several people. And today we could have been playing at funerals instead of praising God and blessing this church. Oh, I'm happy tonight. Let me tell you, I'm happy in what I feel in my soul. And I know what I serve. I know I serve a living God. And I know I serve a God that can move a mountain if he wanted to, because I saw some stuff moving the other night. And I prayed. I never prayed so hard with my Lord. I think that was a lesson I was taught, was to hit my knees. In a way that I can't hit my knees because I can't get up when I get down there. But I'll tell you, I prayed in that little window. I prayed in that strike. I said, don't let anybody get hurt in this storm. I don't want to have to listen
that someone in our church has been hurt. And Lord, spare this church.
Yes.
Spare the building so we have someplace to go to.
Yes.
And when I looked out there in the parking lot that night and saw everybody praising God, I said, Lord, that's some people that love you right there.
Yes, love you.
There is some people in that parking lot, Lord, that love you. Oh, I appreciate him tonight. I appreciate what he's given in my heart. Oh, I love him. I love him. And Lord, keep me here. Keep me right here, Lord, to serve you. Oh, and let me be merciful to other people. And let me be kind. I want to have a kind spirit for everyone else. And a love in my heart for God's people.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God.
Come on, Brother Daniel. Praise God.
I already shared it with Pastor Marlowe, but I need to share it with the rest of you.
Yes.
Last week, we wanted to stay home, but then the Lord said, no, you have to leave. I says, okay, but Lord, we have a full tank of gas and zero money in our account. So we got in the car and we started going. We're going to North Carolina.
Yes.
And I said, how far are we going? And then our daughter-in-law calls, say, how are you doing? I said, we are on the way. We're almost out of Florida. And she says, do you have any money? I said, no, we don't have. We have zero in our account. So she says, she sent the money through Walmart. He said, where are you going to be? I said, we're going to be in Georgia by then. So she put $92 in our, not in our account, but through Walmart. So we stopped in Valdosta and picked up the money.
Glory.
Now,
glory.
We are going, we got $92 in our pocket. No money on any other way. So we are going, and he said, well, the tank of gas is just a little over a quarter of a tank. So we need to stop and get some gas. So I said, we saw the Love's gas station. So I said, well, we'll stop there and get it. Love's is a good name. So we pulled in, we're waiting in line because there were people in there. And Gene says, I'll pump the gas, you go and pay. So I says, okay. So I'm walking over there toward, and all of a sudden, you know, I'm almost to the door and she calls me, said, Daniel, come back. I come back, said, what's the matter? Man came over there and said, blessed us and filled our tank with gas. Right there, I said, praise God. And then we finally got in North Carolina, and then Sunday morning we're going to church with the people that with Charles and Lena Sutton, the ones that were here. So we're going to church with them. There was a Free Will Baptist Church, and I blew the shofar there. And then I talked to Pastor, and all of a sudden he introduced us, and he said, we're traveling, we're from Florida. After the service, there was an awesome service. Two people came over there and gave us $120. I said, Lord, now we got money to get back home too. So Tuesday, finally, we started going back. On the way back, the traffic was just wall to wall. We were in a parking lot on 75, and we're just going, and you know, we had such a favor of God all the way through. And I says, you know, Lord, you are our provision. You are our Jehovah Jireh. You are everything to us. Yes, He is. And thank you, Lord, that we were able to get back, and you know, and he provided everything on our trip for us. So we didn't have to worry about anything. He says, I am your provision. I am your everything.
Amen.
So thank you, Lord.
Oh, my God. We got to praise him for that.
Oh, yeah. We, on the way back, too, we stopped at the rest stop, and they fed us for free.
Glory.
So God was our provider all the way through, all the way back.
Provider.
Yes, He is.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Testimony. Amen. And encourage your heart. Their faith and God answering. Their faith and God answering.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
their faith, no money in their pocket, headed north, and all these things are happening.
Yeah.
Praise our God. How big is our God?
It's a big God.
Sister Jean. Sister Jean. Amen. Brother, bring the mic back down. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I probably don't need one. I have such a big voice.
Thank you. I just want to add to that, saying that sometimes what is obvious to our mind and our understanding is not really what the Lord's got in His mind. And you know what we learned, but especially myself, I can stand here tonight and say that my faith elevated during this experience, because we're sitting there perfectly willing to hunker down and go through the storm, and then getting this overwhelming thing that we had to leave. And through man's understanding, he might classify that as a fear. But see, my Lord is better than that. My Lord does not cause fear. He does not cause condemnation. So whenever you receive condemnation from someone in a form of anger or fear, you can know at that moment that that's not of God. Because God never, even when He corrects us, He does it in a loving, gentle way. There's never condemnation. And so when we left on 100% faith. 100% faith, because when we said we had nothing, we had zero nothing. In fact, we were minus $8 in one account. But God. You see, but God. He knows the beginning all the way to the end of our lives. Our lives are a puzzle piece, I like to think. And as we go through the trials and tribulations that life throws at us, another piece gets put into that puzzle. And so this mosaic of life that God creates for us, it hones us, it sharpens us. It makes us step out of our comfort zone. It makes us trust in something we cannot see.
Amen.
And I think that's called faith.
Amen.
And so He spoke to me this morning because I prayed, Lord, I want to hear from You more. I want only Your voice in my head. I want to hear from You all the time. And within 20 minutes, I started receiving messages, and God is revealing things to me about Daniel and my life, and His thing is this: trust Me with all of your heart and with all of your soul and with all of your mind. I am your strength. I am your love. I am your righteousness.
Oh, praise God.
Through Me, all things are possible for those who love Me. And that was shown to me today with no ifs, ands, or buts about it. But God. And I praise Him tonight. I stand here and I praise Him tonight. And thank You, the testimony He has given Daniel and I, to hopefully encourage you, to get you to go down to your knees, to say, Lord, what is it in me that needs corrected? Not what's going on with the other guy, but what's going on in me that needs to be corrected or altered, or where am I at? Where am I at? So be willing. Give Him your yes. The amen word is giving God your yes. So be it. So I give Him my yes tonight and my amen.
Praise God.
I have to testify again tonight, because I did testify Wednesday night out in our parking lot, because it was a beautiful, sweet service that we had, and not one mosquito.
But anyway, as I was saying, I had no fear. Even with all the stuff going on and all the news and all this and this and this, but my children were absolutely terrified and said, "Mother, you all get in the car and get on up here." You know, I mean, they were ready to meet us halfway. They want to know, is it money you need? What is it? You know, just come on and get out of there. And we just held steady. We felt to stay where we were, but and here in Florida. And as things went, had never lived in a trailer before, you know. And I told CB, I said, "CB, I heard, I saw a sheriff go through here, and they had microphones, and they were saying, get out, don't stay, don't stay." I said, I guess we're gonna have to do something. So we made arrangements. We got our stuff together, and we came over here and stayed in where Steve Rowland was. And we went in there and set up, and I overheard Brother Matthew say, "We're going to have a hurricane party." And I told CB, I said, "I've always said I won't be right in the middle of everything." I said that up at the campground when a tornado went through. We were in a travel trailer, and we were rocking back and forth. But I said I wanted to be in the middle of everything. So there again, I wanted to be in the middle of everything. So as we went through Sunday, we knew. And Brother Matthew said, "We're going to have a meeting." Well, first of all, they fixed breakfast. The biggest breakfast you ever saw in the sanctuary, in the dining room. And all of the fellowship, it was almost like, well, there's nothing going on outside. We're just having a party here. And we did that. Then he said, "We're going to have a meeting at 2 o'clock so we can give people instructions on what to do." And so CB and I went back to the room. There was one lazy boy chair in there, but our new neighbors next door were giving one away. And I said, "CB, let's see if we can take that chair, and we'll go over there, and we'll both have a chair to sit in." So we ended up with two lazy boy chairs provided, and therefore we had a place to sleep. And we got back there, and we both fell sound asleep and slept till 3 o'clock. I woke up, and I said, "Oh, CB, we slept through the meeting." Well, it happened that one was canceled. So we went to see, he said, "I'm gonna go check and see what's going on." He went down, he come back and got me. He said, "They're in there fixing spaghetti for supper before the lights go out." Well, we had our big old pots. Now, the reason I'm saying this again is because I have had calls and text messages from all over this country. There's people, Brother Marlon, Sister Marlon, that watch this service all over this country. We had calls from just all over. Well, anyway, that's why I'm up again, because God is so good.
God is so good.
And I never felt like that this place would be touched. I knew we had a protection, but I didn't realize what a protection we had until midnight, the lights went out. And I had a little phone, because I had a little tablet, but that wouldn't work with the Wi-Fi, not working all that stuff. So my son kept texting me and sending pictures. And he sent me a picture. He said, "Mother," he said, "it is hitting Marco Island." And in a few minutes, he said, sent me another picture, "Mother, it's hitting Naples. I think 135 miles an hour wind. It's tearing Naples up." Then he said, do you know where Arcadia is?" I said, "Yeah, it's about 50 miles from here." He said, Well, it's headed that way. But, he said, looks like it's starting to wobble a little bit and it's going east. And as it went east, it stayed on the land. And the further it got to us, the lower it was. And as we sat there in that little room and looked out the window, I kept waiting for a rain storm. I kept waiting for wind stuff to go. I mean, it really didn't do much of anything. And I said, oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And Stephen said, but Mother, he said, I'm telling you, he said, the way it looks now, he said, it's not going to touch Bradenton. Now, my son in Nashville was sending that information down to me. So I am so thankful. I mean, you know, God lets you know. He protects you. He really does. And then our little trailer, it was not hurt at all. Well, I did say there was one little trim that said they didn't put enough screws in it to hold it. But you know what? It could have blown away.
Yes.
But guess what? It just dropped down and it was thank there God. When we come on. So I am just so thankful. And this place is so special. It is so special. And Brother Merle has always said that nothing would harm this place as long as there was a church here. As long as there was a people, a true people, that really, really loved the Lord. That there would, as long as we served, right, would watch over us. And I tell you, it's been an experience that I won't forget. I can share it wherever we go. And everybody that has called in from everywhere, just know that Bradenton is standing tall. We are standing tall. And I love the Lord, and I am so excited for what He has in store for this church and this people. And I wouldn't miss it, would you?
Amen.
I would not miss it.
Well, praise God.
Praise God. Praise God. That's Brother Bush.
I'd like to stand up and thank the Lord tonight. Sister Teresian's exactly right. If you were here Wednesday night, you heard Brother Marlowe as he started to preach to us Wednesday evening out in the parking lot. He started calling off the names and the different states of people that was calling, that was praying for us here in Bradenton.
All over there.
It was all over America, all over the world.
All over the world, right.
It was all over the world. The Wyatts called me twice, you know. Brother and Sister Wyatt called twice checking on us. And Brother Marlowe, I have to tell you, the many, many, many more that have called.
India called.
But I'm just so thankful for the way things have turned out. I'm not much of a social media type guy. I do watch, I do check it a little bit. More than anything, I like all the recipes Sister Teresa and the different sisters put on there for food and stuff. I think that's where I get all my weight, is I just look on that tablet with all that food they're talking about. But anyway, I wanted to tell you about one thing. I don't remember just when it was, but I'm sure that other people saw it also. But as I was flipping through the tablet one evening before, of course the tablet was all right, but before we lost power and Wi-Fi, on the storm, there was a picture on there, and it showed the storm and the direction and the turmoil that the atmosphere was in. But it also showed that there was a heart that was just as clear, and you could see the land, and it was right over Bradenton. Did anybody else see that picture on social media? It was amazing. It was absolutely amazing that the storm is going on, and there was a heart, and it was right over Bradenton. I was mesmerized by that. I would love to be able to get a picture of that and to blow it up. But I wanted to remind you all of that very much so.
Our house, we live in Parrish, and at the time, as Tara said, was saying when they said that it was going up the west coast, it looked like the bullseye was headed right across our house. And I'm thinking, oh, Lord, please. And so we began to prepare, and we put up wood on the windows and everything as best we could because we chose not to leave. When we thought it was going up the other coast, we decided to stay, and then it came about us, and we just waited too long, so we had to ride it out. But we put all that on our home, and Sunday evening, our home is two-story, and the bottom is concrete block, and the top is wood. And so I was concerned about that. I mean, I really, really was concerned about that, and especially if it was going to be a Category 4 or 5 come through this area. And so I commenced to pray in Sunday evening because we had, you know, we had our son and his family, and then we had our two granddaughters from college, and Carol and I, and then we had another person from Orlando, and they got scared, and when it was going to hit, so they took off and went back to Orlando, and Lord, that's where it really hit, you know. So, I mean, but anyway, that Sunday evening, I kind of got off to myself and I started praying, and I know in Proverbs, in the 18th chapter, in the 10th verse, it talks about the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and I know what that means as well as you know what that means. But I prayed to God that He would take my home and He would make it a strong tower, and it would be safe for my family that was there. And when I went and was praying for that, and that scripture came into my mind, I heard Sister Deidre Harris Wingate singing "The Maker of the Rain." I heard her voice singing that song, "The Maker." I know the Maker, the Master of the Wind. I heard her singing that song, and it just really kind of soothed me. It soothed me, and thank the Lord that the thing turned. The only damage that we had at our house was we would lost a great big old tree in the back of our home. There's a wooded area, and luckily it fell into the woods, because if it had fallen the other way, it would have hit our house, but it fell into the woods, and we lost a little tree in the front yard. And we had two shutters that blew off our house. Well, they were false shutters. They didn't serve any purpose anyway, so they wasn't any good, so that was not a big deal. But I thank God that he protected our family. Yes. He protected that. Yes. And I kept checking with everybody here at the church, and I kept checking in with Brother Farias and every single day, sometimes more than once a day, to find out about you and where everybody was and how everybody's power is. And all my kids, finally, the last one got her power back tonight. So Sister Harris, you know, we're gonna pray that, you know, you get your power. I think you're probably one of the only ones in the church that doesn't have power now.
Brother Pete doesn't have it yet.
Well, Brother Pete's got it made. He's living with Brother and Sister Marlowe now over there. He doesn't even have to spend money for gas to go to work. He just walks across the street now. So he's just as happy as he could be. So,
thank God he's happy.
Anyway, I'm very thankful, and I thank you all for praying. And we prayed for you, and it was so nice to come to church, even when we sat out in the parking lot Wednesday evening. And it was a little warm, and we sat out there and we prayed, and God saw our spirit, and God felt our spirit, and lo and behold, we go home, and then what happens about 11:30 that night, you know, God said, let the lights come on. So thank the Lord for all that, and, you know, if we can be of assistance to anybody else that needs anything, please call, and I just thank the Lord for all.
Amen.
Opportunity to get on my feet about it, because what the Lord showed me through this whole thing is how powerful He is. Just how powerful He is. I may not have power in the physical sense, but we have power in the Lord Jesus Christ. And in Psalms chapter 29, verse 4, it says, the voice of the Lord is powerful.
Yes.
The voice of the Lord is full of majesty.
Yes.
And now tonight, as I think about serving the Lord in all the years that I have served the Lord, that I'm so thankful that I chose to serve the Lord, and the Lord chose me, because he has the last word.
Amen.
He's powerful.
Amen.
And if you look up the definition of majesty, it is sovereign authority. So we spoke authority as a church. We came together and we spoke authority and said, bypass us. And you know what? The Lord heard our cry, and I'm thankful that the Lord heard our cry. So tonight I'm thankful. Yes, I am a little, I guess you can say, tense, because it's been that long since I haven't had power, but the Lord's showing me some things, and that's okay. He's working on us, isn't he, kid? He's working on our spirits. But you know what? We're going to get through it, and that's okay. I didn't stand on my feet to say that I'm defeated, by no means, and no stretch of the imagination, but that he has the last word, and he's all powerful.
Lord, let their lights come on.
Yes.
Send them power, Lord.
Yes.
Amen. We serve Jehovah.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
All right, we serve Jehovah.
Thank you, Lord.
She's about to run around here. Praise God.
Come on, sit on her.
Sure, all of you knew the reason why I left. My sister passed away, and so we went to give her her final farewell. Everything went well. It was another crowd drawer, and thank God. And then it was like I could not get out of the island. We suffered the effects of what Cuba got, because we're right in their backyard. But God. And as we watched the news and saw the directions that the storm was going, I remember Saturday we just gathered in my sister's house, and I said, let's pray. I said, sis, in fact, when I got home, they stamped 1 year in my passport. So I said, if anything, I can stay there for a year. Right, the guy didn't, he just, and I looked and I said, what? I said, Anyway, make a long story short, I'm so glad tonight we were singing these songs, but this line just stood out. Jesus, my greatest position. Jesus, my greatest position. And I remember on the island last week when we realized, and as we watched the news and saw which direction it was going, I said, look, I'm not going home to anything. But I said, I've learned to hold things with a loose grip.
Amen.
If you take up a handful of sand and hold it like this, you will not hold much. But if you take a handful of sand like this, you'd be surprised to know how much sand you will hold.
Amen.
And over the years, I've learned just to hold things with a loose grip. Paul said, when Christ, who is my life, shall appear. And as we prayed, I told them I might not go back to anything. There's nothing. Where I live will not survive this. And we held hand and we prayed. And I said, God, my sister died at the right time. And all my relatives from London, Canada, U.S. Virgin Islands, BVI, the British Virgin Islands, we all gathered here at the right time. And I said, God, you do not make a mistake. You took my sister at the right time to get all of us on the island at the right time.
Amen.
And those who left the day after the 2 days after the funeral, they got back at the right time, wherever they were going. And when I saw what happened, eight of my relatives right now are stuck in Jamaica because they cannot go back. But you know something? We're alive. And in our prayers, I thank God even for taking my sister at the right time. And I said, God, I might not go back to anything, But I thank, and we had a thank you service
yeah.
in our living room.
Yeah.
Because the Apostle Paul said in everything, give thanks. And we had a thanksgiving service in our living room.
Hallelujah.
And we just came to one conclusion.
Hallelujah.
This has to be the working of God.
Amen.
I couldn't come home on Monday. Our airport was hit by lightning, knockout communication. American Airlines and other airlines could not even come in. So we suffered the effects likewise. And yesterday, it was like, I have to stay here. Like, there was no possibility of me leaving yesterday. But thank God, 1:35 this morning, I hauled my little suitcase through the door like a drunkard. I was so tired. And when I pressed my pillow and look at the clock, it was 2:35. I said, oh, God. But I'm home.
Yeah.
And I can say, Jesus, my reason for living. Jesus, my soon coming King.
Yes.
But Jesus, my greatest position.
Yeah.
If where I live had gone, I would still come in here and thank God.
Amen.
It wouldn't faze me because I serve a God.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Elijah the prophet was out there being fed by a raven. He drank from the brook. But God told him one day as the brook was drying up, he said, I have commanded a widow to sustain you. And there are times when we hold on to our positions as tight as we can hold it. And there are many times God has something more for us. And there are times he just has to pluck it out of our hands and leave us with nothing to sustain us the way he wants to sustain us. And I'm so thankful tonight.
Amen.
Our little place, we didn't even lose power. There's a pile of rubble right in front of our house. We have no idea who it belongs to. Another house over there, the roof is like this. And all around us, we lost two little pieces of tree. And by Tuesday, one of my neighbors came and I was told, Dennis, that you just put it back. Who could it be? I just gave everything to God. I said, God, you give it and you take it. I said, you can have it. But deep in my heart, I've always asked God for a heart of gratitude that no matter where life takes me and no matter what winds may blow, I can always say, thank you, God.
Yes.
Jesus, my greatest position. Jesus, let him be your position tonight. Someone said we could be planning funerals here. And Sister Rosales, I want to extend my condolences to you and your family. And I want to thank this church for all your support and your cards, your call, your prayers, and, you know, your kind words of comfort. Losing a loved one is not easy, but thank God we have a hope. My sister left a testimony on the island of Jamaica. I tell you, it was not a funeral. I remember the minister said, if you think you are at a funeral today, you are at the wrong place. Who wasn't there, I couldn't tell you. But thank God. And I'm going to say again tonight, Jesus, my greatest
everything.
Jesus,
my everything.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
I just want to give honor and glory to my Lord. My Savior.
Yes.
Nothing really scares me. As I go through the years and all the experiences and the things that we've been through. And but you know, I've said before, you can do anything to me, but don't touch my family.
Yeah.
And I said to my wife and my family, I said, we're gonna stand, I'm praying, and we're gonna be all right. But then as we were watching the news, and they said that he had turned to a Category 5, and that it was going to come right through Florida.
What they said.
I started, you know, my mind started working, and I said, you were asleep, and the water, the flood comes, and I said, well, my baby, she doesn't know how to swim, you know. My mind started working. Yes. And I just caring about my family, and I said, what if one of my children drowns? And I started feeling fear, and then we came to the Spanish service, the bilingual church, and I was sitting next to Pastor Farias, and I started feeling the Holy Ghost just stirred me. I felt the Holy Ghost so strong, and I rose up to my feet, and I raised my hands up, and I started feeling the power of God, and I started crying, and I started walking this way, and walking back that way, and walking back this way, and then the church started rising up to their feet and started praising the Lord and feeling the glory of the Lord. And when they all sat down, I rose up to my feet, and I started speaking to the church, and I said, I was going to run away to Georgia, and I already had made up, we had talked about it, and I said, we're going to go to Waycross. I said, because he's gonna come this way, and by the time he gets, you know, in here with us, we'll be down in Georgia, and then we'll come right back. And I was right here, and the Holy Ghost told me, the Lord spoke to my heart, and he said, I'm your covering. I'm your protection. And you're children of the Most High. And I rose to my feet, and I told the church, I said, the Lord spoke to my heart, and he said that we're covered, and that we're, he's our protection, and that we're children of the Most High, and that we're safe, and we don't have to run nowhere. I said, because he's going to cover us and take care of us. And the church just started raising their hands and praising the Lord, and the glory of the Lord came down. And the next day, let me tell you something. We went through that. We rode that storm, Pastor Marlon. And Brother Matthew, I got up and I woke up and I opened my door and I looked out, and my neighbor was coming across the street, and I walked out, and he says, "Hey, man," he says, and he stood right outside the fence and he was looking. He said, "Did you get up and rake your yard already?" I said, "No, sir. I'm just getting up just now." He said, "Well, how come there's no branches in your yard, and everybody else is, you got limbs and branches and trees in there, and you over here, your yard looks like you already raked it." He said, "You got lights?" I said, "Yes, I have lights." I said, "My daughter called last night, and she was afraid and scared, and I told my wife, I said, you tell little Diana to stay at home, that the Lord told me that we're protected, that we're covered, and he's taking care of his children. I said, you tell little Diana to stay at home." I said that they're going to be all right. She told my wife, she said the windows were rattling and that they were scared and that they were going to come to the dining room. I said, do you tell little Diana not to go to the dining room, to the church? You tell them to stay at home, that they're covered. Then the Lord spoke to my heart. And next day, she had lights. We have lights till now. But it's only the love of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. And I told Pastor Marlo I was going to rake my yard. And I called Clark and Jose and Abraham, and I said, let's break our yard. And the little leaves that were around there. And I turned around, and I saw Pastor Marlo dragging a big old limb. And I said, wait a minute. And I said, no, let's go over there to Pastor Marlo. And I yelled at him. I said, what are you doing dragging that big old branch, Pastor Marlo? And I said, he said, Brother Ada, thank you for coming over here and helping us. And I said, well, we're here. We're your sons, Pastor Marlo, and we're here to help you. But I thank God for the Holy Ghost. I thank God for the covering of God. I thank God for the protection that he puts over his children. Hallelujah. I just want to thank the Lord. I just want to appreciate him for what he's done for us. We didn't have to run away. He took care of us right here at home. Hallelujah. Brother Matthew said, man, he said, I wouldn't have stayed in that house for nothing. I said, you should have been there, Brother Matthew. I said, those metal tingles were making some kind of sound. I said, you could have sang it right with those metal tingles. And he said, I would have done that, Brother. I thank the Lord, and we love you all. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let's got another praise.
He's great tonight.
Our God is great. Sister Diane back here.
Amen.
They just can't hold back.
Don't hold back.
Amen.
Amen.
everybody's testimony and stuff, you know, about the storm and stuff, and, you know, it can be a little scary, but, you know, like Brother Bush said, you know, what he said about Sister Deidre, the song, you know, the master of the wind. He is the one who controls it all.
Yes,
the disciples, when they were in the boat, they feared. And Jesus woke up and he said, Peace, be still.
Yes,
and the seas calmed, everything calmed, because he is the one who holds it all. All I can say is that God is just everything.
Go ahead and give it a prayer.
He is everything.
Lord, amen.
Words cannot even, I cannot even say it fully as far as how great God is. I'm just, you know, he is Jehovah Jireh. He is the Prince of Peace.
Yes, he is
the Almighty God.
He is
and because of who he is, because of who he is, we give him all the glory.
Amen.
We give him all the praise.
All the glory.
I'm trying to calm myself down, but it's just this feeling, the Lord is so just bubbling inside, you know.
Go ahead and
if I may, but it's I want to sing this song. It's just been burning in me. Because of who you are, I give you the glory, Lord.
The glory.
I give you the glory.
Sorry, just bear with me. I'm a little bit shaky, but it's all for the glory of the Lord.
That's right.
Give you glory.
Sing it.
What a mighty God. Why don't we pick that chorus up right there, Sister Marla? What a mighty God we serve. Amen. Let's worship the Lord, church. Don't dismiss the service before God does. Amen. Amen. Stop this dismissing the service before God does. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. God hasn't dismissed this service. Praise the name of the Lord. 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 What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, hallelujah. We've all witnessed to the last few days. What a mighty God we serve. I'm going to give him the glory. I'm going to give him the praise. Amen. Let's sing it, children.
What a mighty God we serve.
Sing for us before we leave. Amen. Sing for us, Sister Mary. Come on, anything God gives you, doesn't matter. A verse, it could be a verse. Praise God, just obey the Lord. Obey the Lord.
While Sister Marilyn's coming, I just want to tell you one of the greatest things the Lord did for us. You know, we had this, my husband's favorite teddy bear. They found him tied in the yard, and he just has panic attacks. And when it thunders or lightnings or storms and keeps us up sometimes all night, he slept through the whole thing.
Sister Marilyn, praise God.
I've heard all of your testimonies of how God brought you through the storm. What a mighty God.
What a mighty God.
And you know, that's what God wants us to do. When he blesses us, he wants us to tell somebody.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
Come on, Sister.
I wasn't expecting to sing a song, but it's an old song. But that's all right. I'm still blessed by old songs. How about you?
Yes, yes.
The song
says,
"Go tell it on the mountains,
oh, yes.
Over the hills, and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ."
He had risen from the dead.
For the gift he gave your tongue tonight to speak like you have. Have you enjoyed the worship?
Amen.
Has it lifted your soul tonight? Have you felt the Holy Spirit in you? Encouraging you, blessing you, teaching you, talking to you. I'll just add this footnote. We have a great day in the morning. In prayer for Brother Matthew and the Build the Bridge Assembly of the Schools, where he's been having his meeting, still is not in a position to let them have it. So we'll just pray, and God has everything in his hands concerning the mission, Build the Bridge, Brother Matthew and his leadership and the church there. And he takes care of his own. And I can tell you from 67 years, Brother Matthew, never fear. God has control. It's all right directly in his hand. And I speak that to you as a father in the Lord.
Thank you.
And one that can encourage you in the Lord. And then we want to pray much for Brother Stewart, because he goes, Sister Jerry goes, they beat that highway. It's dangerous between here and Port Charlotte. God watches over them every Sunday.
Yes.
Anytime you can go and lend a hand to the Port Charlotte morgue. We have a van we provided every Sunday. It goes out of here. Brother Rob is faithful to drive it. At 9 o'clock he leaves, and he's punctual. He leaves at 9, and that you can go, and you can minister. You can hold up a hand of Brother Stewart. And you can show the bolstering, backing, encouraging spirit. Any of you saints can do that. Anyone's welcome to do that. And I know we had a tremendous service there Thursday night. God blessed and came in that place and lifted the people. I find that the more I labor for God, the more he gives me life, because he is my life and he's your life. He is our life. In him was life.
Yes.
And that life is the light of men.
Amen.
And the light shineth in the darkness.
Amen.
And the darkness doesn't comprehend it.
Amen.
Praise God. So we have a great day tomorrow. Bilingual here at 10:30. And that's a tremendous move of God. And God is helping that work. and you'll be blessed. And 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, let's just keep the work assembling together and together and together. God's been good to us tonight and giving us great things from God. I'll add this footnote, and just tomorrow I'll let you give that thought announcement. I know that through this storm, the Lord has just opened up a brand new chapter to me.
Yes,
he just opened up a brand new book to me.
Amen.
I feel so refreshed in the Lord. I feel so lifted up in the Lord. If you came to me and I started talking discouraging to me, I would tell you to stop. If you came to me with a negative spirit, I would tell you to stop. Because there is no, this is no time to be negative.
Nope.
This is no time to let a spirit of gloom or doom be anywhere near the church. After the victory God has given us, Israel should be shouting all over the hills. Praise the name of the Lord. Look at what God has done for you. Israel should be shouting. I feel for you, Sherry, and no power there. We'll do anything we can to help.
There's no dinner in the dining room tomorrow.
No, there is no dinner. In fact, thank you. I'll say more about that tomorrow. We need cleaners and workers here next week. The dining room needs a thorough scouring, cleaning. There's been a lot of activity in there, a lot of people, and yes, dogs, birds, cats. It was all in the through the weekend. And we were protecting the birds and the dogs, and I believe in protecting my dogs. I told Teddy, I said, Teddy, if you're going to be a prince somewhere in the creation of God, I know nothing about it. I don't preach that dogs have a soul that moves on alive like I do people. But I secretly in my spirit, I think there may be a rainbow bridge over there. Somewhere for me. I said, if you're going to be a prince, and you start behaving yourself here and on this earth. So somehow you may say, things like that don't go anywhere with God. But wasn't he a good boy, Sister Marlo? Wasn't he a reformed fella? I've never seen the likes. Praise God. And so God is good.
And his daddy snored.
God is good. Praise God. So we just thank God for all these good things. Remember, God loves his people. We'll need cleaners and workers. Tomorrow night, I need two or three sisters to volunteer ahead of time to take care of the nursery, because we're going to have some folks come up for service. And they asked me, Brother Marlo, do you have any sisters in the church that would volunteer to care for our children in the nursery? I said, come to church. We have so many willing sisters in our church, they practically trod one upon another to take care of children in the nursery. I said, so we'll have more than needed. Bring your children and come to service tomorrow night. We're here to win souls, aren't we? We're here to invite people to come, aren't we? We're here to serve, aren't we? All right. And three or four of you sisters, alternate. You can alternate time, 30 minutes, and take care of some youngsters in the nursery tomorrow night. We'll look forward to that. Praise God. I think this is a serving church. I'm going to be looking around and indicating serving all over the place, because we're servants of the Most High God. Praise the name of the Lord. God is good all the time. And if you are, do you feel blessed tonight?
Amen.
If you don't, you don't have to say you do. But if you feel blessed,
amen,
give the Lord a hand clap. Give him a shout. Jehovah Jireh has provided. And there's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. He is the mighty God. Let's rise up and give him a praise offering. Amen, amen, amen. Father, we lift our hands right now, and we lift our hearts right now, and we lift our spirit right now, and we lift our thoughts right now, and we give you the praise. And before we leave here, we're going to fill this place with a glorious shout unto the King of Kings. Praise the name of the Lord. And everybody said, praise the Lord. Everyone said, praise the Lord. Oh, how good he is. Well, worship him tonight. And may he bless you and go with you right now.